This week on Land Beat, we're evaluating three different sites in Western Florida and how they may or may not be benefiting wild turkeys and white-tailed deer. All right, guys, 3 years ago, this site was clear cut. It's been reseeded in a longleaf pine. But what's really important is to look at the species that are coming back, and most importantly, the structure or composition of those species. In this specific site that's about 3 years old, we've got the perfect composition, structure, and density of shrubs, stump sprouts, forbs, and grasses if you're a wild turkey. This site is extremely usable. It's really good for nesting, but even better for brood rearing cover, and a turkey can come through here, navigate the site really, really well. From a deer's perspective, there are forbs in here and there's woody browse, so it's extremely usable. It's not the best of cover unless you're a fawn. It doesn't have much shade value, but there is forage value in this specific site. This is about 3 years, 4 years post-harvest in a sandy soil environment. This is the response that we're getting here in Western Florida. Obviously, in this specific site, it's gonna favor the wild turkey, its life cycles, more so than it will deer, but deer will still find value in these acres. From a top-down view, you can clearly see how the clumps of shrubs versus the clumps of longleaf and grasses with mixed forbs and bare ground is gonna allow for there to be cover for wild turkeys, poults. Navigating this site, you can clearly see that composition and distribution of the plants here make it a highly used site. All right, guys, now we're standing in site number two. This is about 5 to 6 years worth of regeneration since that clear cut and the planting of longleaf pine. We have now changed the composition of what's been growing on site. Now the composition of the same species has changed as more time has passed. We see a lot more growth, height structure out of the live oak, scrub coming back. We see a little bit of switchgrass and a little bit of little blue, but not those bigger clumps. See a little bit more of the wiregrass coming in, and the actual composition and structure has drastically changed. We've got more upward growth, and that produces more cover for white-tailed deer, more movability for white-tailed deer compared to the next site that we're gonna see. But the wild turkey and poults has definitely decreased in its ability to move and navigate this site. Forage value from insects being in here for the turkey, and as well as the forb growth, has probably decreased in this site as well, but the cover for white-tailed deer has increased. So having a balance of both sites one and two on your property is prime. Let's move on to site number three. All right, guys, we're in the third location here in Western Florida. As you can see, this site is the densest, it is the thickest, structure is at its tallest, and it's obviously had the least amount of disturbance or the most time in between a previous disturbance. So as we've moved through and compared the other sites, this is a lot less usable for quail, a lot less usable for wild turkey, and getting to a point where it is much less usable for even deer. Yes, it is super dense and it is secure, but some of the actual forage, the forbs, we're not seeing nearly as dense in here, or the herbaceous plants, and some of the woody plants are getting too tall. It's kind of closing back in. So the live oak, the longleaf, the sand pine, magnolias are coming in. We're getting a lot less conducive for many of the species. So if you see this height structure, again, we're bolting. One of the best things to do, because we don't have a lot of fuel on the ground to carry a fire and be aggressive or hot enough to reset some of the oak and the hardwood saplings in here. What really needs to happen here is a mechanical reduction first. So coming in with a mulcher and allowing that to reset, basically kind of restarting the hardwood sprouts, you get back to an earlier successional stage. Then you can reintroduce fire and have a much more desirable condition or site where you can achieve a lot more goals for deer, turkey, and quail. So this site, a little too far gone for optimization of deer and turkey, and especially quail.